What is up, expats and travelers alike? Today is day number 12, Tallinn, Estonia.
What do you think?
Yeah, Tallinn's pretty cool. It's definitely a city on the rise. The downtown core is historic, it's medieval, but then you look in other directions and there's a lot going on.
Yeah, they seem to be growing a lot. Down in the old town, since it's summer, lots of tour groups, lots and lots of people. So if you're going to visit during this time, be prepared that you'll have to navigate in and out of people. But it's because it's so great to see, so everyone wants to see it.
Yeah, the Old Town Square was absolutely packed. So it's really difficult to get a good shot of anything that you really want to get a good shot of, so you got to be patient. I don't really know when a good time to go there is.
No, because it probably gets cold during the winter. But a couple of highlights is the Nevsky Cathedral. It's got those really pretty domes on there. They still have a lot of their wall around the old town, so that's really cool to see with the arches that you can go in and out of. They've got a lot of nice parks, a palace, so lots of cool things to see.
Yeah, and actually, once we got out of the city center area and started kind of walking around the perimeter, seeing what else there was going on, we came across near Freedom Square, right? A film shoot. So there's this film that's going to be coming out next year in August, or that's when they're expected to release it, called O2. It's a spy film. Man, the set looks so cool.
Yeah, they were doing, it looked very old-timey, and they were on the clay tennis court, so they were shooting there. So we're pretty interested to see the movie.
Yeah. We asked them if it would be in English or English subtitles, because it's an Estonian film, and they said, maybe. So we'll see.
I think one of my favorite parts of walking around the city was in the old town. It's the oldest apothecary.
Oh, yeah.
It was started in 1422, and it's still open. So you can go in there, and you can see practices from a long time ago and different machines that they used, different animal stuff that they used, but then it's still active. So it's still a pharmacy that you can buy today's stuff.
Yeah, you can get your modern medicine there.
Right. So I thought that was really cool to see. They've done it really well. A lot of tourists go in there, and they've got a good flow to see everything. And then if you need to pick something up, it's not burdensome.
This other area that we went to, and it was probably my favorite, was Rotterman Quarter. Rotterman Quarter is where they've taken like these old factory buildings and they've converted them. And you have bars and restaurants and cafes and shops, and it's all just kind of like retrofitted into these old buildings. It looks so nice. It's just super cool.
It seems like a place where tourists and locals would go to, so not just one or the other.
Yeah, it's a little higher end than you would find a little further out into the suburbs.
There are a variety of museums you can see around the city too, and they're quite different types of museums, so I think everyone could find something that they would enjoy.
Yeah, from art to architecture to Estonian culture, whatever you want to learn about, you can learn about. I guess we've come to that time where I've got to ask that question. Kaylee, would you expat that?
Dun dun dun. I would say yes, I could expat Tallinn. I don't know if it would necessarily be my first choice to expat if I could choose anywhere, but I think it would be quite easy to be an expat there. And you?
Yeah, I'm going to agree. So of the Baltic countries that we've been to, we've certainly seen some that have lower costs of living. And for that, it could be good for maybe your digital nomads. But for those of you that are going to potentially work there with a foreign company or an international company, then yeah, Tallinn would be awesome, and I would say go for it, and I would expat that. I would expat the heck out of that.
Yeah, it seems like it would be easy to be an expat there. One surprise was the cost of living and cafes, restaurants. The prices seemed higher than a couple of the other surrounding countries we've been to, so that was a little bit of a surprise, but not bad.
Yeah, not bad at all. It's certainly a little cheaper than Western Europe, for sure.
So we soldier on, and tomorrow we are in St. Petersburg, Russia.
St. Pete. No, not that St. Pete. St. Petersburg, Russia.
And we are there for 2 days, so we'll bring a lot of content to you.
See you guys.
Bye.